Good evening, everybody. It is Thursday, the 11th of November, and me and Matilda have just arrived at Arley Hall at the Harry Potter Forbidden Experience. So we've just parked up. We've parked up back there. They seem to be sending people forward now, but I don't know why. So we've just parked up in the car park. We're going to walk over now. We've got our wellies on because we heard that it was super muddy, and it actually is really muddy. It's a bit of a pain, this now, actually, because cars are like right next to us driving on the way that it's directing you to walk. Oh my gosh, yeah, it's really, really muddy on this car park. Super good job we put our wellies on.
Yeah, super good.
Right, we will catch up in a minute when we get to the front, and I will let you know what it's like. Oh, exciting. So we got out of the car park eventually. You can't really make it out here, but it is super, super muddy. I've tried to put like some kind of stuff down for underneath feet, but it's super, super muddy. There's kind of a bit of a not very well organised in that parking situation. There wasn't any way directing me. We just kind of came towards the light, and there's cars driving at us, at the side of us, all like trying to pull up spaces, people pulling out. It's nicely lit here though, so we're just basically following this all the way along now, which is where I'm assuming we'll then be the check-in for it, don't we? Yeah. See a sign, so on we go.
The first of which being at halfway, which is halfway around our trail. I know, we're very creative, aren't we? We put all the rest of the creativity into this amazing forest around you. So you can get something to eat and drink and go to the toilet and have a sit down if you need it. If you need a member of staff tonight for whatever reason, we all have these little blue lights on, so you'll be able to find us really nice and easily. If for whatever reason our blue light goes out, sometimes they get stolen by the creatures in the forest, you'll be able to find us by these big Hagrid lanterns at all times, so don't worry about that. Speaking of Hagrid, he has brought some spiders into the forest.
Hello.
If you're not the biggest fan of spiders, that's absolutely okay. They are hidden away. You can't go and see them unless you choose to go and see the spiders. We have a load of surprises waiting for you guys in our forest. None of them are spider related, so don't worry. There's no one jumping out at you or anything like that. Or if there is, it's not one of ours. It will be one of your friends. Okay, last thing. Hi guys, come on in. We've got space. Hey guys, come on in, there's more magic in the circle. Does anybody know what this is?
What is it?
It is, it's the Deluminator. Well done for people that knew. And I'm going to use it to put out all of the lights and send you guys on your way.
The Deluminator turns the lights, doesn't it? Remember, it lasted to Ron, didn't it?
So on the count of three, can you give your wands or your straws or whatever you have, your torch, a very big but very careful wave, and we're going to put out all the lights, okay? If you don't have a hand or a straw or a torch or a wand, sorry, just give your hand a wave for me, okay? Three. Two, one. And once more for the other side for me, guys. Three, two, one.
Oh,
and if everyone could look towards our really pretty trees for me. Have an amazing time in there, guys. Thank you so much. One last big wave for me, everybody. Three, two, one.
Woo-hoo.
And now have an amazing
time. Okay, so we did our ticket, didn't we? You literally do come through where we came through, did our ticket, and listened to this lady just doing a little talk we just listened to then. And then now we're on our way, so you just basically walk around by yourselves. So it's super excited. This looks like a funky tunnel. So we'll take you along with us and we'll see what else we can. Okay, so this is the first thing that we've come to. So far it's just been walking through the trees, and it's just been like clips from the movies and things, and it's been talking about them. But now we've got to Hagrid and Fang. So going in the forest, aren't we? Look.
Right. Let's go.
Hagrid's off. Into the forest. Fang is going to lead him. Should we follow him into the forest? For the first like couple of minutes walking through them was just kind of like this, like foresty bit, the lights change. It had different quotes out of the movies. And then the first thing we've come to is Hagrid there. So now we're just following the trail around again now to see what we come to next. What do you think is going to be next?
I don't know, but wherever it is, it sounds scary.
Oh, it's up on here, look.
The stars are aligning.
Wow, look at it.
And I sense we will have showers.
It's the centaurs.
Prepare for the worst.
Look. Wow.
Now, It is time you leave.
Ah, that's funky, isn't it? Look at them. I love that. They're actually moving as well. Yeah, because we're in the Forbidden Forest now. Oh no. Oh, something's coming.
Beware of strange creatures in the night. Best not to disturb the forest at this time. This is where you leave. Good luck.
This is where we leave. Oh no, he's told us we have to leave. We've got to be aware of the strange creatures.
Whatever happened to
Buckbeat
though?
Buckbeat? Well, he flew off with Sirius on him, didn't he? Sirius flew off on his back. Here's Buckbeat. Hello, Buckbeat. Hello, Buckbeat. Look, he's like, oh, he's moving. He's moving, he's bowed. Oh, wow. Wow. How funky was that? So this says, sign, here's some little signs. Guests should take particular care on this trail during full moon cycle. And we just thought, like, you can just about make out as like flashes of eyes in the distance. And growling noises. You can't see anything though, we just hear the growling, can't we? Oh, something's growling over there now.
Yeah, more eyes.
More eyes. Oh, there's all smoke coming up now. Oh no! It says you're tasty.
Oh, that's no body.
To scare you, isn't it? That's why. Don't worry, he's not gonna get you, don't worry. This is where strange creatures are active at night. Oh gosh. Is that why you're active at night? Oh, can you see them flashing there? Look, the eyes, look, they just lit up and they went out again. What's this here? Looks like something was tied up on that tree somewhere. Looks like something was tied up there on that tree. Wonder who's been tied up there. Oh, I think I might be able to see who it was. I can see him here. Who is it?
Oh, he's so cute.
Who is it? What's his name? Gorpy! Gorpy! So I think we're halfway around now because we've just come to a toilet spot, and then there's this boat opportunity here where you can hold the wand either side for the green and the red, and then there's some little shops here and some little seats. So we're going to have a little look. So this one sells butterbeer. Oh gosh, that's quite expensive. £7.95 for a butterbeer. Then this is the Forbidden Forest Emporium. So they look like the book clothes, wands. Oh, the little green stick thing, yeah, baby nifflers. This is a price thing here. You can see, oh, they've got a scarf, gloves, bobble hat, 30 bots flavour golden snitch. Oh, they're quite good. Okay, let's see what's on the next one. The Cauldron Cafe, magical treats. Cake, donuts and muffins from £4. Okay, 1 minute, 1 minute. Hogwarts hot chocolate. Milk hot chocolate with whipped cream, marshmallows, chocolate flake, perfect for big and little muggles. I love that. Oh, they've got donuts and stuff as well. I'll zoom in quickly so you can see the menu up there. So just a little look. We have just finished in the food village, so we got the hot chocolate to share between us, and Matilda got the Niffler donut, and I got the cherry blondie. The blondie was really nice. the Niffler donut didn't really have anything, did it, Missus? It didn't have anything inside it. And the hot chocolate was £4.95 and it came to about £15. I'm thinking the other thing must have been about £5 each. And then when we've come out, we've now come to this. So this here is where you can cast your own Patronus. So they have wands for you if you don't have a wand. So literally the food area is just literally there, and we've come round here. So we got in the queue straight away, but then we realised that there's actually another queue here. We would have maybe walked a little bit further. So you can borrow a wand, and then you just cast your Patronus.
I got a badger, and Mum got me.
And it goes like this.
Mum's escaping.
So, Matilda, you got the badger, didn't you? And what did Mummy get? I got the dog, didn't I?
Yeah. Oh, what did that
say? Beware, escaped shrews in this, scroots, sorry, in this area. Oh, it's all green now. So you can see you're completely like under a massive canopy here with the trees. It is really, really beautiful. And you can just kind of go at your own pace. There's nobody rushing you. You can just, you know, I'm not even sure we're near anybody who we kind of started with, but obviously we stopped hot chocolate, we've stopped at different photo opportunities. So I suppose the time, like however long you spend here, depends on yourself really and what things you want to stop for, what you don't want to. Oh, there's a blast. Oh, look. Blast ended scroots. Oh, no. Look, they've blasted out. Oh no, they're going to be around here somewhere.
I did see, I
see the unicorn. Where's it going? It's here, Matilda. What's this way? Walking through. Oh, it's coming back. Look, it's coming back. Get it there. Harry! I hope it's not the Whomping Willow. It sounded like they're in that car, wasn't it? Oh yeah, look, that's the car. See it there, look, in the tree. I just saw it then, I think. Oh, where's it gone?
It's over there.
It's over there. Oh no, it's flying somewhere. Where's it gone again? Somewhere else now. Oh no, I hope he's not in the spiders. Oh, not where it went. We've just found some symbols on the trees, they just keep lighting up. There's one. I've just seen how the buckle pops over there. Oh, we can see the Deathly Hallows symbol. Did you see the Deathly Hallows one then, Missus? Look. Oh, look, Matilda, look at that there, the wolf one. There's one there as well. Mind your step. Niffler burrow in this area. Let's see. Let's try and see if we can find the Nifflers then. Oh, look at that lighting up and down. That's pretty, look. Look at the mushrooms, see them lighting up and down. Can't find any nipples in there. Oh, have a kiss like Harry and Chow. Oh, under the mistletoe.
Where?
There, look, the mistletoe.
Haha, that's funny. Oh, that ring looks like a mushroom.
Yeah.
Look, the mushrooms are
green.
They're blue.
They're so pretty.
It's so blue.
It's like a garden, isn't it? And mushrooms. Right. that. Guests are advised to keep all personal belongings hidden. Oh, what are we hiding them from?
The
nifflers. The nifflers. Let's see. Oh, look, that could be a niffler burrow. Look, it's all shiny.
That is gold.
They love shiny things, don't they? Look. It's a niffler burrow, look. There's all there. One's been in there.
Oh,
one's been in here too. Oh my gosh, look at that. The nifflers have been in there. Oh, don't let him take your golden coin. Oh, look at the nifflers. Oh no, look at them. They're all in there. Look at those. Hi, nifflers. Don't steal my car keys. I have a feeling we're stepping into spider territory. Because all of a sudden, there is webs in the trees.
Look, all those lights of eggs.
It's the spider eggs.
It's just some little children.
If you're any way frightened of spiders, please speak to our staff member ahead. So it must be like, if you're scared, then don't go.
Let's go to our gog slide this way. This is our gog slide.
Way.
Let's go to our gog slide.
Which way is it?
Want to go to our gog slide?
I don't know which way it is.
Our gog slide is in there.
Yeah, I think we might be waiting here to get into it, I think. Our gog's in. So it says Aragog's lair is this way, or if we go straight on, so you can go straight on, that avoids it, and that's just attached to the main trail. So you don't have to go this way. Oh no, you can't take the spiders home with you, he said, if they jump on you. Oh my gosh, so we're in Aragog's lair here now. I'm a bit scared. Hagrid, is that you, he says?
Spiders everywhere.
Oh, look up. Oh, he's there, look.
There
he is. That's me. Is that a dog? That's me. Is that
going to
jump out of the desert?
Oh, yes, yes.
What's happening? Oh my gosh! Look at that! Oh my gosh, I can't believe all the spiders are coming out of my head. Oh, that was the end of it. Jeez, that's
that
good.
Was great, wasn't it?
But that's, oh, where? Oh my gosh, that was a bit freaky. Are we out now?
I guess so you don't touch them.
Oh yeah, so that was the way in, so we're out of it now then.
I'm guessing.
Okay.
Yeah, those are doxies.
Doxies? I thought they were pixies.
No, they're doxies.
Pixies? I remember they were pixies, weren't they, when...
Doxies
are four. What was the Defence Against the Dark Arts teacher who had them? The one who lost all his memory in the end.
Lockhart.
Professor Lockhart, that was it, wasn't it? And he let them all out, didn't he? And he couldn't get them back in again. Oh, look, it's meant to be the pixies, I think.
Pixies
are flying.
Oh, look.
Little hedgehogs.
They're not hedgehogs.
No.
They eat people.
They eat people?
Yeah, gosh. I read about it. Just kidding, they're really good pets. Like dogs in the Wizarding World.
Oh, okay.
And you don't even need a
magical. Oh, the pixies have gone now, I think. Oh no, they're in that tree! Pesky pixies!
Oh, I actually
up to mischief! In there! Pesky tree!
This one's a very popular wizard pet.
What are these, like hedgehog things?
Yeah, they're a very popular wizard pet.
Oh, right, what do they do? Oh, look, that looks like the stick people, look, see?
You can
look!
Teach them.
There's the tree, the stick trees. See them?
They're basically
look.
Dogs. Right. It's like a
look at them. See them?
Yeah.
The family. So this seems to be the end now.
Well, guys, welcome.
We've come out of the pixies and everything like that.
One final surprise all in store for you guys.
So we are going to keep you here for 2 minutes, just while we get a bit of a group accumulated, and then we'll get you all moved down to the bridge. At the bridge, you'll find the finale, so make sure you have your phones ready for that point, just so you can get all your pictures and your videos as well. If anyone's got any wands in the hands, make sure you've got those ready as well, because you might just see some dementors.
Oh no.
I know. So you're going to have to cast a spell to keep your family all safe and sound as well, so make sure you've got your wands ready. After you have finished at the finale, you will find yourselves in the village. Now the village is your final destination, where you can spend as much time as you'd like. There's no rush for there. You have just walked through a forest, so if you want to take a load off and take a seat, you're more than welcome to do so, as there's plenty of seating. If you want to grab some nice hot food to warm yourselves up, we've got a fish and chip stand.
Oh, yeah.
If you like Sunday dinner, we've got giant Yorkshire puddings for all your Sunday best and gravy as well. There's also an open fire pit for the kids to roast marshmallows. And then once you've roasted your marshmallow, you can cover it top to bottom in nice, hot, melted chocolate as well. Don't forget, don't worry guys, we've not forgot about you adults as well. There is also a bar for you guys as well to enjoy yourselves. And then you'll find yourselves in the Forbidden Forest Emporium. The Emporium is filled top to bottom with all your favourite Harry Potter best bits, all the merchandise and souvenirs. So if you want to start your Christmas shopping early or just grab a souvenir, you're more than welcome to do so this evening, guys. So, we do hope you've had a grand old time, really enjoyed yourselves. Make sure you've got your phones all ready. And then what you're going to do for me, if you want to head down just to where my colleagues are, give you a nice big wave. If you want to head towards them, they'll get you all situated, guys. So, once again, thanks for coming. Have a lovely rest of your evening, everyone.
Okay, so we've been told to wait on the bridge here and do not cross it, because this is the finale. The bridge now into what Matilda, you are right, does look a bit like Hogsmeade Village, doesn't it? So I'm not sure what it's gonna be like over here or what the price is gonna be like.
Marshmallows for roasting.
Yeah, the lady did say that. I've just seen that in the video, but we'll see how much that actually is, because
there's five that can see it.
Spent £15 on a hot chocolate, a donut and a cake. Then there's the gift shop, so they definitely know how to get their money's worth out of people when you go in these places, but we'll see. Let's have a little walk around then and see what they've got. Oh look, Matilda.
I see something
there. Oh, you can't see the water, remember? Because not a lot of people can see them. Only if you've seen death, yeah. Can you hear it though? So it's definitely there. You just can't see it. Yeah, let's walk around and we'll see what type, what food they've got. So the corn is Pixie. Pastry shawl. Oh, that's so cool. What a great name. Cornish Pixie. So they've got bangers and mash, £11.50 now. Sausage, large loose roll, child sausage roll. You can see them here. Hot dogs, chips, crumbling sausage. Yeah. Cornish pasty. You get the Cornish Pixie pasty. And this seems to be a bar. Oh, the floating pumpkin, fruit juice, vodka, pumpkin, so it's been a pumpkin dust, mulled wine, wizarding winter warmer, spiced mulled cider, so with cinnamon, that sounds nice. Dragon fire, chocolate sponge, jams and spotted dick. What's in this one? Dragon fire roasts. Oh, this is a giant Yorkshire pudding, this one, isn't it? A roasted mini Yorkshire pudding is £12. I've got roast meat, £7.95. British roast salmon. Mini roast dinner. Wow. This one. Oh, this one just looks like the same one again, doesn't it? That we got before. Yeah, that's what I got before. Morello cherry blondie. Yeah. Oh my gosh, I wish I would have had that huge piece though. Oh yeah, they are like different houses, aren't they? I didn't think of that. That's what you got, the Niffler donut, look. You got that round there, didn't you? Yeah, the Hogwarts hot chocolate was £4.95. You can get all the donuts there. Oh, you can get pancakes. This one's like fish and chips. The Fat Fryer fish and chips. Children's fish goujons and chips, £8.95. Chicken goujons and chips, £8.50. Children's Fat Fryer fish and chips, £8.95 for kids. That's £9 for children's fish and chips, gosh. It's a bit of an expense. It looks like that's the Forbidden Forest in there. Not the Forbidden Forest. What am I trying to think of, Matilda? The shop, sorry. Classic fudge and sweets, £3.19 per 100 kilograms. Finger free. So this is just, it's not really like in the lights around it. It's not like this fudge. Take the phone away because it doesn't really like that. It's flicking. Back to the butterbeer on this side here. We have more butterbeer stalls. So we worked out that the butterbeer is actually £10. I think it's like £9.95, the butterbeer. The butterbeer was £9.95 if you wanted it in a souvenir tankard thing, which is just like a plastic cup. I'm not sure how much it was for without it. I think it was like £6 something. Now we're at the sweetie one. So it's toasted marshmallow stick, marshmallow brownie stick, strawberry marshmallow stick, wands, loaded muffins and toffee apples.
Happy birthday. Fancy
something
to
sweet,
you.
It says. Pretzel candy with chocolate jelly. They're not free, Matilda. Oh, you get three on them.
Happy
yeah.
Birthday.
Not actually sure how much anything is. See if we can go around here and see if there's a price.
Listen, I know. No licking, no munching, no nibbling. When you finish your toasting, come back and give me a star with you. Mm-hmm.
It's a bit cheeky because it's not actually saying how much anything is, to be honest. That says £5.75 there, so I'm not sure if they're actually £5.75. That's a ridiculous price. I'm going to go around and actually ask how much they worked out. It was actually £5.75, which I think is a bit ridiculous. This is Christmas Curious now. This looks quite good. This is like a little Christmas shop. Yeah. Oh, they've got calendar, Matilda. That's cute. Look at these. I like the calendars. They're cute, aren't they?
You enjoyed it?
Okay, we ended up paying £5.75 for this, which is actually a bit of a ridiculous price, but somebody really, really wanted to do it, so hey, we are entering the shop. So it says no eating or drinking inside this store. And we've got Christmas things there. So, here's a little look at the prices. Hedwig stocking, £16. That's not too bad, actually, I don't think. It's quite cute. We've got all the sections. So we've kind of got Slytherin, Gryffindor, Hufflepuff, Ravenclaw. Oh, yeah. All I want for Christmas, a Nimbus 2000, a toad, a pair of socks and a snitch. I don't know how much they are.
Look, they even have like a frame.
You don't they? So they've got the hoodies, 35, sweatshirt, 40, t-shirt, 20, scarf, 25, adult gown, 30, zip up hoodies, 50, wow.
They have like a huge Hedwig collection over there.
Yeah.
Look at all these Hedwig stuff.
Oh, that's cute, isn't it? All the Hedwig things, yeah. The Hedwig bag's cute, isn't it? And a little key ring.
Oh, there's a Dobby
there. It's all the Dobby stuff, yeah. So they seem to just have these little signs here. And this tells you how much everything is.
Oh, there's a goblet.
That's kind of within this section here. So at least you don't have to like keep picking things up, I suppose. It tells you how much everything is.
Look.
It's like this goes away again. So there's Hufflepuff. Okay, so we're kind of back to the beginning now. So we've just come out of this white tent here, which was the shop. That's back to the food area there. So you can come out the shop and go back to the food area. And then the toilets are here. And then this is back to the beginning. So when we came in at the very beginning, we went past the Patronus and we just nipped to the toilets here. But obviously didn't go into the village or anything then. You mean, to be honest, you could go into the village and have food and everything without even showing a ticket, because there's nothing that says you have to show your ticket or anything. And that's the start there. So then this is kind of back to the start. So there is some little tiny shops here that we didn't look at before, did we? So let's have a little look at, no, this guy said, but there's some like little shops. So should we have a look at these little shops? So let's see, I've not seen this one over here, this charming one. So this looks like it's the same like cafe again, where they've got the hot chocolate and they've got the donuts. Oh, they've got muffins at this one. And they've got the brownies and things. Then this one says Hot Pocket Puffs. Plenty of choices. So it's charming concoctions you can get. Yeah, so Gryffindor is strawberry, Slytherin is lemon and lime, Hufflepuff pineapple, and Ravenclaw is raspberry. So it's the house cup. Yeah, that's if you get a special one, it says. The £5 each, £11.50 with a souvenir cup. So you'd have to pay like £11.50 to get a light up cup. And then again, this is the same kind of thing again, the donuts, the hot chocolate, the muffins. And then over here is the forest, in Forbidden Forest Emporium. And then again, that's where we went in before. We scanned our tickets and went through. So there's people still coming in now. And it is now 8:30. So our reservation was 10 to 7, wasn't it? And it's 8:30 now and we've just finished. So that's a little shop as you first come in. So I suppose if you wanted a wand or you wanted like a jacket or something when you first come in, you could get that from here as you start off on your journey. And it says, oh, filming in progress. Your presence here allows us to use your image for marketing and promotional purposes. Okay, so that's just a little kind of lay-by bit before you even get in. So I suppose you could start, some people had hot chocolate walking through and mulled wine and things. And then this is the big long path all the way back to the car now, isn't it, Mrs? Come on, Mrs. Okay, so this is going back to the car. This is people that are now trying to park up, people that are trying to walk back to the car. It is the muddiest mud ever. Keep going, missus. Keep going. We were right through here, wasn't we? Oh my gosh, it's so scorching. There's more people that have walked on it at night, the muddy that it's got. But as you can see, there's kind of no pathway, like cars are just driving at us again. Yeah, I would recommend coming at night because it was so pretty, wasn't it? All lit up and everything. It was really nice, but there obviously isn't really a kind of, there's not really a method to how they park. I think it's just as people go and there's a few more spaces, they'll just park more people up. But then this just seems to be a line of cars here now waiting to come through to park up. Whereas we're trying to, well, actually they might be just trying to get out. We've got to try and get out somehow yet as well. And I've also got to try and remember where we've parked. So we'll catch up in a minute.